Now, focusing on matters business, that did you know that your employer is now liable to pay you 1 million shillings as a fine for wrongfully withholding or deducting your salary? Well, this is according to the new Employment Amendment Act 2019 that raised a penalty from 100,000 shillings, with the law also setting gratuity pay for duration of termination of a contract at not less than 15 days per year.
The new Employment Amendment Act of 2019 amended the Employment Act of 2007 in measures aimed at introducing fairly progressive labor practices in line with the current global trends. Among other major amendments, the new law stipulates that an employer who wrongfully withholds or deducts worker's salary is liable to be fined up to 1 million shillings, the figure having been revised upward from 100,000 shillings that was previously the threshold.
In any event whereby an employer unlawfully and without just reason withholds an employee's salary, then they will be penalized upon being reported even to the labor offices to a fine of up to 1 million Kenya shillings.
The amendment law also delegalizes non-compete laws, which are in the same instances termed as restrictive covenants. This will give employers the right to work for any other company or venture into businesses with similar undertaking with their previous employer. An employee who resigns or whose contracts come to an end is only mandated to guard information regarding the previous employer for only a reasonable period. The new law also states that in case of a transfer, merger or sale of a business, the deal should not automatically lead to the loss of employment or redundancy. It further states that an employee's right will continue existing after the death of an employer, and the personal representative of the deceased employer will have the responsibility of exercising it.
Employee's rights subsist even after the death of an employer, meaning that in the unfortunate event of an employer's death, then someone who in law is called as a personal representative will be responsible to exercise those rights that are affiliated to the employee.
A redundancy situation will, however, arise where a business ceases to exist. The new act also introduces a 1 month maternity leave in case of a stillbirth. To further enhance safety in workplace, employers with 5 staff members are required to have a sexual harassment policy. Previously, the threshold for a sexual harassment policy was for organizations with at least 20 employees.
Provided an employer has more than 5 staff members, then they ought to have a sexual harassment policy in place.
Sick leave will be at a maximum of 30 days with full pay, and 15 days on half pay for all employees in a year, and not only staff who have worked for more than 2 months. During dismissal, an employer must provide an employee with a written statement of the reasons for the dismissal. During termination of a contract, a gratuity pay of not less than 15 days per year is mandatory.
The new act actually provides for better job security to the workers. It also provides for better remedies in the event that the employer is oppressive or rather reneges against the contract.
Benson Ryoba reporting for Channel 1 Business.